What can I take with my meal to prevent harm from the oxalates in the meal?
This is a clip from a live Q&A session open to CMJ Masterpass members. In addition to this episode, you can access lots of other free samples from these sessions at the first link in the description.
Hey, Chris.
Hey.
Hello. My question today is about what I can do when I know I'm consuming oxalates. Is there something I can take, like maybe potassium citrate or some sort of supplement to inhibit the absorption of oxalic acid?
I would make sure you're getting 300 to 400 milligrams of calcium in the meal.
Okay.
Because the calcium binds to oxalate and prevents its absorption.
And that won't go through the digestive tract?
You can't do anything about that. I mean, if you're eating oxalate, it's either going to be in your digestive tract or it's going to get absorbed into the blood. You can't do anything else with it.
Yeah, because the kidney stone is calcium oxalate, yeah?
Well, it's not going to your kidneys if it doesn't leave the intestines.
That's what I'm trying to prevent.
Right. So your best bet is to keep it in the intestines, and calcium will do that.
Okay.
But keeping your urine pH above in the 6.4 to 6.8 range will also prevent calcium oxalate from crystallizing in your urine.
Because you
and,
can
and good alkalinizing things would be potassium. Generally, the potassium salts, not chloride, but food-based potassium would be very effective at that because the potassium is balanced with a variety of organic acids that have alkalinizing effects in the food. And then if you do take a potassium supplement, if it's citrate or malate or something like that, then that would also have that effect.
Oh, okay. What about
the calcium is what's preventing the oxalate from getting absorbed.
Yeah, that's basically the answer to my question. Yeah. What about like sodium bicarbonate for increasing the pH in the urine?
It's kind of a band-aid solution, so I think it definitely works, and you might need to do that, but it's better to have just the raw materials available for the kidney to regulate the pH in its normal way. You know, bicarbonate is kind of like it's a very, you know, quickly but transiently acting way to kind of make the pH change. But you know, if you're doing it chronically, I think that potentially comes to the possibility of some digestion issues. And so it works. It's just you don't need it if you're getting enough potassium usually.
So you were saying a better solution would be potassium citrate or malate?
Well, I think the best solution would be just get more potassium from your food. That's definitely the superior option, but potassium citrate would work.
Okay. All right, I appreciate it, Chris, and happy Easter. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you. Same to you.
This is a clip from a live Q&A session open to CMJ Masterpass members. In addition to this episode, you can access lots of other free samples from these sessions at the first link in the description. If you want to become a Masterpass member so that you can participate in the next live Q&A, or so that you can have access to the complete recording and transcript of each Q&A session, you can join at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass. You can save 10% off the subscription price for as long as you remain a member by signing up at chrismasterjohnphd.substack.com/Q&A. That's Q&A spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A. These links are in the description.